Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to demonstrate how you can create my domain in Salesforce Lightning. If you want to follow Salesforce training videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta on YouTube and you can follow my YouTube channel. So coming on to the topic, in Salesforce Lightning Experience, you can create my domain by searching this option, my domain. So it comes under company settings. So let's first understand what my domain is. So here you can read this description. So my domain step one, this says, showcase your company's brand and keep your data more secure by adding a custom domain name to your Salesforce URL. So you can see this is a Salesforce URL and in the starting this domain is displayed. So if you want your custom domain, then you can do this by setting up my domain. Further, it says, because having a custom domain is more secure, some Salesforce features require it. Further, it says, it's easy to set up my domain. The hardest part is choosing a name that your stakeholders can agree on. So you need to choose a particular name for your domain. So further, you can see there are total four steps. First step is choose domain name. Second, domain registration pending. Third is domain ready for testing. And fourth, domain deployed to users, right? So choose your domain name. So here you can read this description. Enter a domain name and click whether it's available. Be sure of your name before registering. Only Salesforce customer support can change your domain name once it's registered. Then your domain name can be up to 34 characters. It can include letters, numbers, and hyphens, but it can't start or end with a hyphen. So now I'm choosing this domain for my org. Sanjay Gupta hyphen tech school, and this will be appended by default. Now we need to check availability. So it is showing it is available. Then I'm going to click on register domain. So further it says, after you click register domain, Salesforce takes a few minutes to update its naming registry. You receive an email when it's done, right? So I'm clicking on register domain. So now we are on the second step, domain registration pending. So it is reviewing this and we will receive an email. So here you can see you have to do a refresh, then you will be on step number three that says domain ready for testing. So test domain URL, then deploy to users. So this your domain is this and your domain name is ready. Login to test it out. So I'm clicking on login. So in this URL, you can see domain is available now, and earlier it was showing like this, instance specific. Now your domain is specific to the name that is provided. So now it is logged in with this domain. Then it says deploy to users, so roll out the new domain to your org. So click on deploy to users. When you deploy the new domain, we activate it immediately. Only Salesforce customer support can disable or change your domain name once it is deployed. So you can click on OK. So here you can see your domain name is this. You can click on edit if you want to change something. So if we click on this edit, so if you click on this checkbox, so it says prevent login from login.salesforce.com. So this applies to every login except SOAP API. So if you don't want to allow login from login.salesforce.com, you can check this checkbox. then redirect policy. So you can read and apply this as per the requirement. And this is a domain that we need to use. So right now I'm not checking this. Then authentication configuration is available here. You can edit and select a particular feature that is required, right? So this way you can create your custom domain. So I hope you understood how we can create my domain, that is a custom domain name to your Salesforce URL. So now you can log in with login.salesforce.com as well as with this domain, right? So if I refresh this, so right now it is not available here. So if I use this window and suppose, let's say I click on setup to open this in new window, new tab. So here you can see this custom domain is available. So I hope you understood how we can create my domain by following these four steps. So if you want to watch more Salesforce training videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta on YouTube and you can follow my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching this video.